Vincente, where does this idea of light and cast another show come from?
Well, this is the third exhibition I curate of Karsten, and we never repeat shows. So each show has to be different, has to have a focus so that it will shed new light on the artist's work. So in this case, first we have into consideration the place. Is the museum of EDP, which is the electrical company in Portugal, next to the old station. And then also Lisbon, it's the city of white light. And the space. The space is a kind of, I call it the belly of a whale. The building looks like it's a whale emerging from the river. And we said, okay, let's go to the belly, let's use the building as it is. That's what we usually do. We don't build walls, we don't build rooms. We remove all the additions. And then we, because you have to be truthful to the space, because the works of Karsten, they invade the space, they appropriate the space. And we needed a starting point. And the starting point was an old project that we had discussed when I was at Tate Modern for his Truman Hall intervention. Before designing the slides, he tried to do the Lisbon dots, these dots that would, with colors that would chase people, and then you could steal the dot from another one and change it, and bring it to another color. But at that time, technology was not ready. So 16 years later, he said, technology is ready. So I said, okay, so it's perfect. And in a way, it's a kind of, it incorporates also this kind of disco spirit. All his works have a kind of parascience, but also popular culture, popular attractions, you know, like the real world, popular world going in a scene through a kind of mad scientist.
But why is Karsten so accurate with light? Because everyone is using light today.
Yeah, well, as you have seen, his first work in 87 was already using light. But it uses light in a very, in both physical and ethereal way. As you perceive it, not only with your senses, but also with your body. This dialectic is what's present in his work. And that's what makes it very special, because it's the kind of yin and yang. It's the contradiction creates doubt, and doubt is at the base of research, scientific research. And lately, I helped introduce some works with light, like the light corridor we did for Anger Bicoca, for the show there, and also the double neonatal elevator we helped produce. So, the first work, you see the 7.8 hertz, which is here in front of the river, which is kind of daylight effect, that was done last year. So, it looked like a perfect combination, because he had been working more and more with light in the last years. And so we said, okay, day, but day also implies night. So, light and darkness, which is what you have in the exhibition. Because we removed all the lights of the exhibition space except security signs we had to keep. And then, but whenever there was natural light, which is in one part of the exhibition, which you get light from the street, then we left it as it is. So, and finally, what it creates is a kind of loop. And loop is also very disorienting, because finally you don't know, where am I? I'm on the right side, I'm in the left side, am I going, am I coming back? So it's a kind of loop whirlpool. This state of confusion also, in a way, is the beginning of creativity.
Merci.